Hi, my name is Chuck Ries. I'm an engineer on the Visual Studio Debugger. Today, I'm going to talk to you about scenarios related to debugging external source code. This means code that you're not building as part of your project, but maybe coming through the .NET runtime or a NuGet package. These features are range in options around symbols and source link, as well as looking at the external sources node in Solution Explorer. All right, let's get started. So I have pretty much default Visual Studio settings, just my code is on and I'm not loading any symbols. I don't have any symbol servers configured. Here we have a pretty normal scenario where I have a function that I'm going to pass a lambda to that I'm going to get called back on. So array.sort is going to take this array and I'm giving it a comparison to sort by. So when I step into this, you'll see that I land in my lambda function. If I look at the call stack, there's where I called array.sort, and then there's some external code, and then there's my lambda function. So this external code is actually the .sort method in the .NET runtime. If I want to look at that, I can actually click show external code, and the call stack window will show me those frames that had previously collapsed. If I want to start to look through these to get a sense of what array.sort is actually doing, I can click on these in Visual Studio. And the debugger is going to decompile this source for me. So this source code, this actual text, isn't what was sent to the compiler when this was built. This is a view into the DLL that's running in the runtime. Its IL instructions have been converted back into a human readable C# file. And so this gives me a sense of what's going on, but names and formatting and layout and sort of the overall style of the code is going to be different from what it looked like originally. But this is a great way to start looking at the code and getting a sense of what's happening. A lot of times you can do a lot of debugging just by looking at decompilation. There's one thing I want to note, though, is that because the .NET runtime is so heavily optimized, especially by the CLR's JIT, a lot of these methods cannot be seen in locals because they've been optimized away. This is a common problem when debugging external source, is that it's built in release configurations and it's heavily optimized. If we want to look at all of the source available to us, we can go to the external sources node in Solution Explorer. This will show every module that has symbols loaded, and we can browse through its available sources. Because we've decompiled this, this will be organized by namespace and type, and we can look at the decompilation of any type. If we want to jump directly to the file that we're in, we can use this button that's sync with active document, and it will take us to the file that we're in. From here, we can begin to browse anything that we want from the module. The next thing we would like to be able to do is actually step in and debug array.sort without needing to worry about all these unavailable locals. To do that, we're going to have to change some settings. We're going to go to debug options and look at the general settings. We're going to disable just my code, and this is going to allow us to actually step into array.sort. We're going to go to the symbol settings. We're going to turn on Microsoft symbol servers. This is going to allow us to download symbols for the .NET runtime from Microsoft. And finally, we're going to change this setting from automatic symbol load to load only specified modules. This is going to keep us from downloading all the modules or all the symbols up front, and Visual Studio will only download symbols for us when it needs them. With those settings in place, we're going to start debugging again. Now, when we step into array.sort, we'll notice that instead of landing directly in our comparison function, Visual Studio is going to download the symbols from the symbol server. It's going to find the source file from GitHub, and it's going to drop us into that. So now we can step directly through this code. We can even step into the next function. What you'll notice while we're doing this is that the locals are staying available. Nothing is showing as optimized away. And that is because in Visual Studio 2022, if you're debugging .NET 8 or newer, the CLR is going to rejit to debuggable code when we step into it. And this makes debugging external source really, really powerful. If you step in or set a breakpoint in external code, the CLR will de-optimize it so that it's a much better debugging experience. So those are the things available directly from the .NET runtime. But what really makes source link and symbol indexing powerful is when you can do it for your own code and your own NuGet packages. Here we've got some dependencies, that we're pulling from NuGet.org and Azure DevOps. I'll look at the project file so you can see we're pulling in these two NuGet packages. They both have symbols indexed and they both have source link enabled. So that allows us to do external source debugging very easily. If I run here, let's go adjust our symbol settings. I go to debug options, symbols. First, I'm going to turn on NuGet.org symbol servers, which will allow us to get symbols from NuGet packages. And then I'm going to add a new Azure DevOps symbol server, which allows me to get symbols from Azure DevOps. And this will show me all of the Azure DevOps servers that I have available. And I'll just add the instance that built this package originally. So once I've done that, similar to what we did with the ray.sort, I can step in and Visual Studio is going to download the symbols and the source. And I can debug through this, even though I haven't built this as part of F5 on this machine. If I step out, I can come down here. And I can do the exact same thing for the dependency that came from Azure DevOps. I get full debugging and full inspection. I can jump into the browser to show you these projects. Here's the GitHub source link demo, which is available online. Here's the do magic method that we called. We can look at our project file over here. And in .NET 8 and later, source link is enabled by default. Any .NET code you built will have source link enabled. If you're running before .NET 8, you simply pull in this GitHub package, which the links will be available, and your project will be built with source link enabled. Once you're building with source link, you can look at the GitHub action that we created to build this repo. All we had to do was configure the .NET pack to use symbols, and then we simply pushed our NuGet package along with its simple symbols to NuGet.org, which we can see here. You can see that the download symbols option is available on NuGet.org. If we want to look at our Azure DevOps repo, similarly, you need to pull in the source link NuGet package or be running on .NET 8. If we look at our Azure DevOps pipeline, it's very similar. We simply had to pack, and then we had to use the task publish symbols to make sure that the symbols are available on Azure DevOps. This has been a glimpse into some of our external source code debugging features. I hope you have a great day.